In this video, we're diving into diastolic heart failure. You've probably heard about it in nursing school, and you definitely need to know the pathophysiology for it. So I'm going to walk you through the four steps of diastolic heart failure so that you can finally understand it for nursing school. Let's do this. Hey friend, my name is Christina Rufano from NursingSOS.com, and here on the Nursing School Show, we give you the tips and the resources that you need to be successful in your RN program. And today, I've got another step-by-step video for you. I know you love things broken down step-by-step, and today it's all about diastolic heart failure. So, when you think about diastolic heart failure, I want you to think of a big, big muscle. So your heart is a muscle, right? And when it works really, really hard, that muscle gets bigger. And that's what's happening during diastolic heart failure. The heart has to work super duper hard, and its muscles, those ventricles, get bigger. And this happens, the ventricles can't relax as much. They get really tight. So let's think about this. When you go to the gym and work out really hard, your muscles get bigger. And what do you do afterward? You stretch your muscles out, or else they'll get really tight and tense. And that's exactly what's going on here in the heart. The heart has been working out super, super hard, but it hasn't been able to have a break to stretch. So over time, it just gets bigger and bigger and more tight, and the heart just can't relax. So let's put this into a step-by-step process. You know I'm all about the steps, and I know you love them too. So here's a step-by-step process for diastolic heart failure. Now, you won't see these steps anywhere else in your textbook or anything. I'm just gonna make them up to make learning this a whole lot easier for you, because I know you love it. So the first step is a trigger, or a cause. This is something that is causing the heart to have to work super hard. So for diastolic heart failure, it could be things like hypertension. So the heart has a tough time pumping blood out into those smaller blood vessels in the body. Or it could be like ischemia, where there just isn't enough blood going to the heart itself. There's many possible causes for diastolic heart failure, but it's all pretty much broken down into the heart having to work harder, or possibly genetics. Now, the second step of diastolic heart failure is that the heart works super duper hard to pump that blood out, and the ventricles get bigger and they get tighter. And this leads us to step number three, which is where the ventricles of the heart can't relax because they are so, so tight. So the ventricles are getting bigger and thicker, and they can't relax. Now, the fourth step, and the key really to all of this, is a decrease in cardiac output. Now, this is a big fancy phrase for how much blood can the heart pump out in one whole minute. So in diastolic heart failure, the ventricles are getting so big, and naturally there isn't as much space inside of them for the blood to fill. So there's not as much blood inside the ventricles to start out with. There's less blood being pumped out to the body. And this is where you end up with those signs and the symptoms of heart failure. Things like shortness of breath, like swelling, fatigue, crackles in the lungs, and decreased urine output, all of those things. Now, if you're a Nursing SOS member, I have a whole video for you inside of the membership community on the signs and symptoms of heart failure. It walks you through the signs and symptoms that you might see, as well as some critical thinking points, so that you can understand the why behind each one of those signs and symptoms. So if you're a Nursing SOS member, you will definitely want to check that video out. Head on over there, log into your dashboard, and check it out. And if you're not a member, girl, head on over there and sign up. You are going to love it. All right, so that is what's happening during diastolic heart failure. The heart is working so hard that it gets really, really big and stiff, and it just cannot relax. And this causes cardiac output to decrease. So the body just isn't getting as much blood as it was before. So there you are, friend. I hope that this helped you understand diastolic heart failure a little bit better. If you loved this step-by-step guide for diastolic heart failure, write love in the comments below. I really want to know your thoughts. And of course, make sure that you hit the like button, share this video with your friends, and of course, make sure that you subscribe and hit that little bell icon so you can get notified every time we post a new video so you don't miss out on anything awesome videos coming up for you. Thank you so much for being here, friend, and for watching this video. Now go become the nurse that God created only you to be. And I will see you right back here next time on The Nursing School Show. Take care.